मोमोज, श्रेड कैबेज, फ्रेश कैबेज, दिस इज वन कैबेज, वन कैप्सिकम, कोरिएंडर एंड दिस इज फ्रेशली ग्रेटेड कैरेट. वी विल टेक ओनली वन कप ऑफ मैदा. वी आर मेकिंग लेस ऑफ मोमोज. सो एंड देन वी विल टेक ओनली पिंच ऑफ सॉल्ट टू दिस. वी विल ऐड टू दिस, आई विल ऐड अबाउट 2 drops of oil. Later on we can add more, and we will take about 1/4 glass of water, if you can see this much only, and I'm going to knead the dough with this. Okay, mix it well. So I'll just knead and show you. Here we require little bit of water more to knead it, so I'm adding little bit of water like you knead the dough for the chapati. So now just knead it. I think half a glass of water is sufficient. 1/4 more I'm pouring in, and it will become sticky, and then later on you are just going to add on little more of oil to make it soft. Here I have knead the dough, the water went little more, so I added little more flour to this. So I'm adding oil, and then we will make it really soft with the oil. So see, you are going to keep it separately for about, see how soft, just knead it and then keep it aside for about 20 minutes, and then we will just do, I'm going to peel off the garlic and ginger and powder them. So we will keep the dough aside in a bowl. I'm going to cover it for about 20 minutes to half an hour. To make momos, ginger and garlic chopped fine, 1/4 teaspoon of salt and black pepper 1/4. In a small wok I have taken refined oil. To this I am going to add ginger and garlic chopped. I wanted to powder it, but then I thought that simmer the gas and then we are going to chop it. I'm going to add the seasoning, pinch of salt, this is almost 1/4 teaspoon, little less, and black pepper, not much of it, but just to get that extra flavor, and we are going to chop it. Get it little brown because this is the only seasoning that we are going to use in this. So now nice fragrance is coming, and we can check that the garlic is almost done. We are not going to get it brown. It's almost done. Nice flavor is coming out. So now what we are going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of cabbage to this. The whole cabbage that we have kept chopped, because it has water content in it, so we will just dry roast it a little bit. The gas is closed. I'm going to dry roast the cabbage. So mind you, the gas is closed, we don't want to cook it, but we just want the flavor to come in the cabbage. So I have just roasted it, flame was closed. Now I'm going to just get all the mixture in a bowl together. We are going to take the carrots, coriander leaves chopped, and the capsicum. This much seasoning is sufficient. Now we will mix the bowl well, because all the seasoning is in cabbage and the ginger garlic paste. Mix it really well so that the seasoning gets done to the vegetables. If you want, you can saute the vegetables, but because of the nutritious value of the carrot and all, I don't want to cook it. If you want, you can roast it for a minute, but I don't want to do that. I have tasted it. I find the seasoning to be very less. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add little bit of black pepper to this and little bit of more salt so that the flavor comes of the salt. Salt is less. So accordingly taste it and then add the salt. That's about it. mix it well. Since we have added salt, you see this has become juicy. It has lots of water in it. You will just take out in a separate bowl, take out the water and put the dry one in the other bowl. So just squeeze it and take out the extra water from the vegetables and keep it in the other bowl. See the amount of water the vegetable has left. Now this is dry vegetable. We don't want our momos to be wet. So now here I don't have the momo stand. I have taken a wok. We will add 1 glass of water to this only. Then again, this is a normal channi. I am sure you all have at your home. Above this I am going to place the channi and I am going to grease it with little oil before placing the momos. We will grease it nicely and then let's make the, and then we will cover it with the lid. See, like this lid. So here the steam will be formed and your homemade steamer is ready. Here this is the dough and I have taken little bit of it and I'm going to cut slices of the dough to make it into little rolls. So see this water, I'm just going to cover it with a lid and just let it get the steam. We are not putting the chutney here. Let it create the steam. We will put the chutney later and we will use it for keeping the momos. You will grease it with oil and then keep the momos in. Big momos and they all stuck because it was heavy. Nobody tells. So don't add so much of filling. That's the reason that they don't add filling. I thought they are really being miser. But after burning it, I realized that no, you can't add much stuffing in it. That's about it. Roll it. And it's done. So let's just, once it's coming, here they are steamed. I will not, you can see the transparency here. We have taken out the momos. I'm just picking them up. See how transparent they are. Make sure that when you make the momos, you don't put any dry maida in it. The oil is hot. The oil is really hot. I'm going to simmer it and I'm adding the momos in it. And here, the deep fried momos. Make sure that they are not broken momos. So, you just add the oil to it and cook it on low flame. Make sure that your momo stuffing is not too much. Otherwise, the chances to stick on the base of the steamer is more. Tilt it. See how beautifully they are getting cooked and so transparent and so nice they are. Thin, and keep the filling really less. I used to think that they are on purpose not filling much filling in it. But after 2 or 3 trials I understood that the filling has to be less. See, there is one bubble here. How transparent and how lovely they are. So let's just fry them on low flame. Now I have increased the flame and I will tilt it. Because remember that the where the joint is, that side, we have loads of maida and we want it to fry well. It is partially cooked because of the water. We had steamed it. See, momos are almost fried. We will take the momos are deep fried now. I'm taking them out and beautiful momos. If you see, they are so soft. The behind, you can see all the filling and they are done. I'll just cut them and show to you. They are so well cooked and they are very very nutritious, better than the one that you get in the market. See, and the oil, the ones in the market have loads of oil oozing out of it, but this one doesn't much. See, the stuffing is so awesome. Such a nice momo. I hope that you enjoy making your deep fried momo. Thank you so much. Do try making deep fried momos at home. The steamer. See how beautifully they are getting steamed. Only for 5 minutes. I have kept few more. So here, I think our momos are done. You see, I'm going to switch off the gas. We will not steam it fully because we are going to deep fry them. If you're not going to deep fry them, then you can steam them properly for about good time. Out. Let me take it out. Very nice. My momo got stuck and now they are broken. What to do?